Hi guys, in this video I'm going to show you how to copy files from your FTP server to your Cisco router. So this is my Cisco router. This is my Cisco router running iOS XE image 16.12.03 router. So before we transferring the file from my FTP server, we have to make sure we are able to ping that FTP server IP address. My FTP server is reachable via VRF, so I'm giving VRF ping. So I'm able to ping my FTP server. The next thing to check is whether the local router have enough space to copy the file size. So for that you have to give the command show file systems. I'm going to copy the file into my boot flash. So your boot flash, I have free space available. So now I'm able to ping my FTP server and I'm able to check we have enough space available to copy the file into the router, the local router. Now the command to copy file is like you have to give copy. If you give a question mark, you can see all the options. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do that with FTP. The command is copy FTP. /, then you have to give the username of your FTP server. The username I have is admin : then type the password. I have given password, so I'm just giving password itself. Then at the rate you give the IP address of your FTP server, then the location of the file. I kept it in the root folder itself, so I'm just giving slash and then the file name. The file name should match exactly what you have in your FTP server. It is better you can just copy from there and then paste it here. And then give a space. After copying the file, give a space and then give a question mark. So this is the location where in your local router where you're going to put it. So in my local router, I'm going to put it under boot flash. So I'm going to give boot flash here. So if you want to give a destination file name in your local router, you can give here. Otherwise, it will take it whatever source file name it is. After boot flash, give a space and then give a question mark. You can see if there is any VRF involved, you can give a VRF name. Otherwise, you can simply enter. Since in this MyLab, I have a VRF involved, so I'm giving the VRF name. So the command to copy file is like copy FTP. /, admin :password, the username password of your FTP server, @ the FTP server IP address, slash the file name, then the local folder boot flash, and the VRF. So when I give enter, you can see that it's asking the destination file name, whether it can keep this file name where it is copying from. If you given the file name like boot flash : and then the file name there, it won't ask this actually. So since we are not given that, it is asking, I'm going to give enter. So it will store the file in the same file name. So once I hit enter, it will start the download. The file is getting downloaded now. I have opened another session just to check whether the file transfer is going fine. I'm giving dir boot flash pipe include CSR. You can see this is the file name that we are downloading. It's an image. And this is the current size 5136. You can see it is increasing now. So like that we can verify whether the file transfer is happening. Once the file is fully transferred, we can check the file size and confirm. Also, once the file is fully downloaded, we have to verify its MD5 checksum. File transfer is completed and we can check the dir boot flash pipe include CSR 1000V. You can see the amount of file got transferred, and like I said, once the file is fully transferred, we have to verify the MD5. We can just simply give verify / MD5 space boot flash and then the file name, this one. So it's verifying now, and it is showing done. And the MD5 is verified. This is the MD5 checksum value. So whenever you transfer the file from your FTP server to your Cisco router, it's better you verify this so that the file transfer is completed properly. We can confirm that. So that's the procedure, how you download a file from your FTP server into your Cisco IOS XE routers.